got honey dripping right over there, pal. Good to see you. Good to see you. How are you?
Very good.
I'm telling you, how at what age did you pick up the harp and start playing like that?
I picked it up around age 14.
Is that right?
Yeah.
And just, you know, because there's very few people that can play, and especially to your level, that can play, which is a tribute to you. You're amazing job.
Thank you so much.
And as a result of that skill and as a result of that school, you've worked with some phenomenal people.
That little harmonica has taken me around the world a few times, and I'm very thankful for that little.
You work with Bruce, and you work with B.B. King, you work with Carole King, you work with Randy Newman. You've done so many artists that you work with. How is that integrated into their music?
Well, the harmonica is, you know, it's an oddball type instrument, not like guitars or drums or saxes, so you have to work it in very carefully. But with pop music and guys like John Lennon and Dylan and the blues guys from Chicago, the harmonica took a prominence the past 50 years, and I'm thankful for
that. Oh, man, it's great to hear. Tell us back in the day, the Hudson River Rats, such a great group, and it was so big in the tri-state area here. It was huge.
Yeah, basically the Hudson River Rats, Joe, were the backup band for Blood, Sweat, and Tears, and David Clayton Thomas, and those guys went out on the road with him on the weekends and did all these shows all over the place, and then during the week they came back to New York City and they wanted to play some blues, so they called me over here in New Jersey and they said, Rob, would you come out and front the band? What do you want to call it? The Hudson River Rats.
That's such a tremendous tribute to you to come in there. And I know Blood, Sweat, and Tears was really good, and there's a big part of that. Tell us a little bit. You got a new CD coming out called Electric Butter.
Yes.
Tell me about it.
Electric Butter is a big band. I collaborated with Ed Palermo's big band, and we did a musical tribute to some of my musical mentors, like Paul Butterfield from the 60s and Mike Bloomfield from the Electric Flag, and we put it together and did it as a big band, and it's coming out in September.
I can't wait. Well, we'll make sure you have it.
Thank you.
And you can go to robpaparozzi.com to pick it up and order and pre-order it. And then, of course, we take you right to the original Blues Brothers band. I mean, that had to be a riot.
Yeah, well, I got a phone call from an old friend who happens to be here tonight, Tommy McDonald, and he said, Rob, you know, I'm out here working with Steve Cropper and Blue Lou Marini and the original Blues Brothers band, and, you know, I've taken off to do another project. Could you fill in? And I said, well, who am I supposed to be? You know, Jake or Elwood? And he said, they only have one, so you just put on a hat and sunglasses and you're there, man.
And so there it was.
It's been a gas. Yeah, and I've been doing it on and off for the past 10, 11 years, and we're going out this summer. We're going to have a blast over in Europe and Asia and Moscow.
Wow, well, it's a big tour.
Yeah.
Well, I can't thank you enough for taking the time to come over here. You're truly a local legend that we're so happy to have, and
thank you.
Very proud of your career, and you did a good job.